I'm Karina.
And I am Dorian.
And we are the youngest Eurovision commentators, and we love Eurovision. We've been doing this for the last 2 years, and we have a special surprise for all of you crazy Eurovision fans out there. We are going to make mini song battles!
Woohoo!
After we review the two battling contestants, we will say our opinion, and then we will reveal who is our favorite.
Do you think me and my sister agree on everything? Watch until the end of the video to find out
the truth!
Appreciate about the singer is that he is also a songwriter, so his song is personal and you can really hear that his emotions are real while he's singing. The beginning is very magical and then the whole song creates special vibes and you are hooked. Once I heard this song, it got stuck in my mind. Definitely one of my favorites this year. The song is about the hope to reach something that seems unreachable. Definitely one of the most original songs, and it is very catchy, but in an artsy way.
What is up with this water? In the previous years, some music videos have been underwater, like a particular one I remember is Serbia. Oh, what year? 2017, I believe. The song was called In Too Deep. And then now, the trend switched to men. Like, this trend, wow. Like, I don't know what's up with this. This song is definitely one of the best modern ballads this year, and I appreciate it. I don't know what it is, but this song has something special. The singer, the way he sings, everything is just so special. That's why the song goes into my top 10. The more you listen to the song, the more it goes into your heart. I checked out on YouTube how his live performance would be, and I was impressed. This guy is the real deal. Duncan will be slam dunking this year.
I have always been a big fan of Belgian entries because they always have a cool style. Remember Senek and Blanche? I really like those songs. There's always a mix of theory and art in the music and videos. I liked his ballad because it is kind of mysterious and unusual, but I already have my top of ballads lined up, and this is in the middle of my list. Congratulations to Elliot for acing this song. He did a really great job, and I'm sure that Belgium should be proud of their entry.
Belgium, I always like songs from Belgium. And this song isn't an exception. This song is pretty good for me. I think that Belgium can be quite proud of this song because it's very mysterious and it has a little bit of darkness, but it also has a lot of light. The melody and lyrics are awesome! I like Elliot's voice very much, and it's really nice and a bit soothing to listen to. And considering that Elliot has so much talent and that he's mean, I'm actually quite curious to see how Elliot will be when he gets a little bit older. This song has potential to do well.
Netherlands must go straight to the final so they can be on the top of the scoreboard. Great job, Netherlands. Good luck, Duncan. This is one of those timeless, amazing quality ballads that will live a long life after Eurovision is over.
Between these two songs, Netherlands and Belgium, I realize that these two songs are both amazing, but Netherlands is a tiny bit closer to my heart. So my winner is the Netherlands!
the comments down below.
And tell us down below in the comments your winner of the two.